I'd like to show you my entire collection of Smith & Wesson revolvers, starting with my 3-inch 44 Magnum Model 629 Trail Boss. This one has magna-porting on it from the factory. The thing that's neat about it is it increases the flash potential if you're into low light fireworks, which I am. I like using flashier powders like Alliant 2400 or Blue Dot. This is the 617-4 10-shot 22 long rifle. Very accurate, nice trigger. They're getting kind of pricey. Local gun store sells that for $800 new. This is the 586, which some of you may not have heard of because they haven't made it, for about 10 years now, I believe. It's the same as the 686, only it's the blued version. I think these were popular with law enforcement at one time. And this one has an absolutely sickening, awesome trigger. So crisp and smooth, it's like there's no perceivable movement. Double action is really nice too. Very smooth. Love that one. 629, 44 Magnum Classic, 5-inch barrel. Bought this one new back in the 90s. This is the 625. This is, I guess I consider this a target gun. I keep snap caps in this one so I can practice loading with the moon clips. See that? Shoots a 45 ACP cartridge. Also a nice trigger. Very nice trigger. All these Smith & Wesson revolvers are beautiful right out of the box. They don't need any modification. And this monster is the 4-inch 500 Magnum. And I chose this in 4-inch because I wanted the full experience of blast and recoil. And you definitely get that with this. the recoil compensator does an excellent job of taming it. It's not painful at all to shoot. I shoot usually 350 grain jacketed hollow point hand loads that are quite a bit more powerful than what you would normally buy in the factory round. So that's my entire revolver collection. I'll show you what I do when I go to the range with these. When I'm in a revolver state of mind, I like to pack these things up and put them in my Pelican case that I custom built for that purpose. Here it is. It's a Pelican 1550. Took a can of this Plastidip spray-on coating, and I gave it, you gotta start out real light because this stuff will eat the foam. Give it real light coats to begin with. Take the this liner out of the box when you do this, and then once it starts building up, you can lay it on heavier. That way your pick and pluck foam won't break apart into pieces like they normally do. It'll hold up rather well. And each one of these pockets here, which I cut with a electric carving knife, so each one of these is custom sized for each particular handgun, the 500 mag. Then comes the Model 625 45, 629 44 Magnum, 586 357 Magnum, and my 617 22 long rifle. All of my Smith & Wesson revolvers came from the factory fitted with Hogue rubber monogrips, with the exception of my 586. I fitted these grips on here so it would have a feel that was consistent with my other Smith & Wesson revolvers. Thank you for watching.